All right, you're gonna hear a lot of ambient noise because we got a lot. We got a full house today. Gigi's here and Pinocchio's here and Tyler's hanging a shelf. So just as an FYI, if you hear lots of noise, that's what it is. But I've got my coffee. It is 3:30 p.m. and I have a raging headache. So I'm hoping more caffeine will fix the problem. Probably won't. Probably won't. I have quite a video. Boy, have I been working on this one for a while. So we're gonna do a battle of the face sunscreens or facial SPFs. I've tried a lot of these and you're gonna see every single one of them on my face. You're gonna really see what it looks like. I've got my notes here with so much information about every single one of these. And so we are ready, baby, we are ready. One thing to know is that I do have normal to dry skin. Most of the time it's pretty normal, but I do lean dry depending on the year and just stuff going on. I feel like that's helpful to know. And I also tend to prefer a more glowy, natural finish when it comes to like makeup, and that kind of translates into SPFs that I like. I like a little bit of glow, a little bit of hydration. So I figure I'm gonna go in no particular order here, but at the end I will share my like awards for like my favorite one and favorites for certain skin types, etc. Let's dive in. Also, I put Pinocchio's little bed there, and of course he's not laying in the bed, he just wants to use the bed as a pillow because he's a human. So let's start with one that's actually newer to me. It's from Tula. It is their Protect and Glow Daily Sunscreen Gel. It has SPF of 30 and it retails for $36. This one comes with 1.7 fluid ounces. And this one is a chemical sunscreen. Let me show you what this one looks like on. It's definitely glowy, which is exactly how it's marketed, but it does have this kind of slightly greasy feeling to it. I know there are a lot of people that love this, and this I did like. I'm actually wearing it today underneath my makeup. However, I am wearing a more full coverage foundation on top. I'm wearing the Estee Lauder Double Wear, which you may have seen in a recent video I was retrying. If you're curious of what I'm wearing makeup-wise, jewelry-wise, dress-wise, I'll have that all below. But gosh, I feel like I've talked for 10 minutes and I've gotten nowhere. I'm so sorry. Some of you guys clicked on this video and were like, who is this? Why is she not getting to the point? And clicked right off. This one definitely does have a little bit of a greasy feel and look to it, where it's kind of to the point where if you have oily skin, this probably is not the one for you, even if you do want a little bit of a glow. I just think it leans into that greasy, oily feeling that I don't personally love. So the consistency of this is very gel-like. It's just kind of, you can kind of see, it's not like a moisturizer. It really does feel like a gel. And it definitely gives you that dewy look. It has a slight sunscreeny smell. I don't think it's overpowering, but it is there. There are a few I'm gonna talk about that definitely have less of a scent to them. But this one has kind of like a hint of like banana or like pineapple. I know there's like pineapple extract in this, so that's probably what it is. But it does not leave a white cast. In fact, I don't think any of the ones I'm mentioning today leave a white cast at all. So if that's something you're concerned about, I'm about to give you a ton of options because none of these leave a white cast. This is the only one that I've really noticed pilling with of the ones I'm gonna mention, especially in this area. You really wanna make sure you give it time to sink in. But even when I have given it the appropriate amount of time, I still feel like I notice a little bit of it. And what I mean by pilling is like when you put this on and then later you put like foundation on, let's say, and you'll notice like little dots of the foundation kind of balling up. That's the issue I have with this. So I don't think this would ever be the absolute favorite of mine. I don't think it's bad though, and it has good skincare. It's reef safe. They say it protects against pollution and blue light. That's gonna be a theme here. A lot of these say they protect from blue light as well, but it has some skin smoothing ingredients in it that are supposed to strengthen the skin barrier as well. It's got probiotic extracts in it. So it's got some good skincare going on, but it does pill up and it's a little greasy. This is Pinocchio, by the way, if you don't know him. He's my beagle. He's like 5. No, he'll be 6 months, or whoa, 6 years next month. He's a glowing boy. So next one we're gonna talk about is from Murad, and this is the most expensive one we're gonna talk about. It is their Environmental Shield Essential C Day Moisture. It has an SPF of 30, and this one retails for $65. So this is the one that's gonna set you back the most. And I will say this, I like it. This is the second one I've had of this, but that's a hefty price tag. And now I've tried a couple more that I like more that I'm like, would I buy this again? I'm not so sure. I know the first one I got in PR, but this one I did pay for, and I know it was like on a deal, but anyway. This is a chemical sunscreen, SPF of 30, and it definitely gives a very hydrated look. If you see it on my skin, it really blends in like a moisturizer. Like it feels like I'm just putting a moisturizer on my skin. And that's one thing I like about it. It does, however, have a little bit of a sunscreeny smell with kind of a hint of like citrus almost. But the consistency, like I said, really is just like a really nice moisturizer. And I like that. I don't think this is for everyone though. Because it is super hydrating, I think if you lean anywhere near oily and even normal skin, it depends on the level of moisture you like, but it can tend to make your makeup look a little greasier even when you put it on top. So that's one thing to be aware of. I like it. It doesn't pill up under makeup. So as long as I let it sink in for like 30 minutes, I don't have an issue with it looking too oily, but it's something to be aware of that I don't think this is for everyone. And on top of it all, it's expensive. But it does have vitamin C and antioxidants as well. This is a skincare brand, so it's got some pretty good stuff going on. So I feel like I can put this on and know it's gonna be good for my facial skin. So moving along, next is this one from Paula's Choice. I've talked about this one for years. I've tried it for years. This is probably the third or fourth bottle of this I've had. It's their Super Light Daily Wrinkle Defense SPF of 30. So this retails for $33, and this is the one that's 2 ounces. Everything else is 1.7, so you get a little bit more product, and it does say on the bottom, shake it well. This one is tinted. So I haven't mentioned a tinted one yet. We've got one other tinted one we are gonna talk about that's cheaper, but this is a very silky lotion, and that's the perfect way to describe it. It's very silky. The consistency kind of reminds me of a tinted moisturizer. It's thinner, it glides right on. Of course, there's no white cast, and it's a universal tint, so it's still gonna blend into your skin. So let me show you what it looks like on my skin. I do feel like this has this slightly perfecting quality where it just fixes little bits of problem areas I may have and evens it out a little bit. Not to the point where I feel like it's a full-on tinted moisturizer, but definitely enough that I'm like, ooh, like my skin looks a little bit nicer than it did before I put it on. You know what I mean? This is also the first mineral sunscreen I've talked about so far. This has zinc oxide in it, 13%. I love Paula's Choice as a skincare brand, and this has really good skincare. It's got antioxidants in it, which is gonna help against like environmental, you know, stressors. But it also has resveratrol, which can be good for anti-aging. So it's got a lot going on. And on top of that, if you have oilier skin, it's really nice because I don't want to say it's mattifying. It's not. I do think it, but it's not nearly as oily or greasy or anything like that. It definitely is one of the lowest offenders when it comes to like grease. So I feel like this is gorgeous under makeup. I've used this for years under makeup, and it is just beautiful. It's a wonderful product. And this one doesn't really have a noticeable smell like at all. This isn't sponsored by Paula's Choice, but I'm an affiliate with them just the same as, I mean, I have affiliate links for all of these, but with this one, it's specifically to the Paula's Choice site, and you can save a percent off. I don't know exactly what it is. I want to say 20% off of my favorites, and this is on there. So I'll have the link below if you want to save a little money. So I figured I'd mention that. You can get it on Amazon as well for the full price, so you don't have to buy it through my link, but if you did want to save a little bit of money, you could. This is one that kind of surprised me, and it's kind of random in the world of SPF because I don't think like anyone talks about this one, but I happen to have it in PR from a while ago, and I was like, I want to use that up before it goes bad. So it's the Laura Mercier Pure Canvas Primer, and it's their protecting one. So it has an SPF of 30. This one retails for $39, and it is a chemical SPF. So this one I appreciate because you can see it on my skin. It definitely makes my skin, again, look hydrated, but it's not an oily or greasy product. It really does remind me more than anything of just a hydrating primer. And that's exactly how it feels when you're putting it on. It feels like a hydrating primer that also happens to have SPF protection in it. And so I've loved this. It works well under makeup, of course. I mean, it's literally called a primer, so it should work well under makeup. But it also happens to be an Allure Best of Beauty winner. I didn't realize that. So I don't take a ton of stock in the Allure Best of Beauty because sometimes I'll see things on there and I'm like, what? But I figure it's worth mentioning. I don't know. This one is probably the least offensive smell. Like there's really no scent to this at all. It really does feel like an unscented primer. So that is nice too if you're like sensitive to scents. Really breathable. It has vitamin C and E, some antioxidant protection. It's got some good stuff in it, and it just is a very easy, fuss free primer that, again, if you had oily skin, I think you might like this. So next up is the CeraVe Hydrating Sunscreen. This is the tinted one, and this one retails for $16.99 at drugstores. Sometimes you can get a couple dollars knocked off depending on where you're finding it online, you know? But I think they have this in a non-tinted formula as well. I have not tried that one yet. If you have, let me know how it is. I might be interested to try it. This is a mineral sunscreen, and it's said that it is to be a... And they say this is a universal tint, and they even have a little chart on their site, I'll put it up here, that kind of shows that it does blend into different skin tones. Here's the thing about this one. Look at my skin here. It looks like I'm wearing like makeup, right? It really perfects my skin. It covers a lot more than the Polish Choice tinted one does. And the only drawback is it's obviously hydrating. That is literally what it's called. But it can sometimes look a little bit oily, and it kind of depends on the day and what makeup I'm wearing on top of it. But if I were to try to put this on and then put on like a glowy foundation, it would be too much. So I have to be careful what I pair with this or just wear it alone, because I mean, it basically performs like a tinted moisturizer. So it's fragrance free. It has a slight sunscreen smell. So if you're sensitive to that, you might not like it. It's not technically added in. I think it's just the smell of the product itself. You know what I mean? The ingredients. But like a lot of CeraVe's products, it's got ceramides in it, hyaluronic acid, so it's gonna be hydrating. It's gonna be strengthening your skin barrier. And it also has niacinamide, which can soothe your skin. And it's not supposed to clog your pores. So this one is one that when I tried it probably a year-ish, maybe a little longer ago, I was very excited, and when I first tried it, I wasn't sure, but once I figured out that I just couldn't pair it with like other glowy, luminizing products, then I fell in love with it. So really nice and a way better price point than like everything else I'm mentioning, you know? CeraVe is a really nice brand to look at if you're in the drugstore and looking at like really any skincare, their cleansers, their everything. They're really good ingredients. They're created by dermatologists, so it's a good line. You can kind of trust that pretty much anything they sell is gonna be good for your skin. That I appreciate, and the price point is way better than a lot of other skincare that's out there. All right, the next one we're gonna talk about is the Super Goop Glow Screen. This has SPF of 40, it retails for $36, and this is a chemical sunscreen. This one is the first one we're mentioning that has a higher SPF. This is SPF 40. I think every single thing else has been SPF of 30. So looking at this one on my skin, very pearlescent, very glowy. Really performs like a glowy primer amped up, and it happens to be SPF of 40. So it doesn't leave a white cast at all, but I do feel like you can kind of get that Tin Man effect if you put a bunch on and that's all you wear. I do think it definitely performs best with something on top. Now, it performs really well with something on top. So I've paired this with so many foundations. In fact, I'm almost out of this one and I've already bought my next one. It pairs so beautifully. You can see that glow underneath, but once you put really anything on top, it amps that glow down just enough that it is perfect. It is so beautiful. I always say about this product that it's kind of like you took a glowy primer, a moisturizer, SPF, and mix it all into one. And so I feel like you can use it as your all-in-one step before going into your makeup. And that is one thing I really appreciate about this. I have tried another glowy primer that's cheaper. You can get it on Amazon, it's from CanMake. I don't happen to have it, I used it up. So I couldn't even try it on for today, and I'm going through so many SPFs. I'm like, I cannot buy any new SPFs for a while. I've got to use all these up. It's gonna be a challenge, but I can do it. I know my husband will probably help me with some of these because SPFs expired. I'm like, I wanted to do this video, but I'm also like, oh my gosh. But that one is not quite as glowy though. So it's definitely amped down, but it's also really, really nice. So I'll link that below. But it doesn't have like a crazy noticeable smell or anything like that, and it says that it's supposed to be makeup gripping. Actually, the Laura Mercier one said that too. I don't know how true that is, but I do know it looks nice under makeup. I've never noticed anything weird going on. But it also has hyaluronic acid and B5, which can be hydrating and kind of nourishing, and some antioxidants and some peptides. So it's got a lot of stuff going on. I just really like this stuff. And they say that it doubles as a highlighter. So if you wanted extra, you know, glow, you could tap it on like a highlighter, and then you've got a little extra slight SPF protection in the area, I guess, too. It's reef safe as well. It's got blue light protection. And this was another Allure Best of Beauty winner, if you were curious. But if you have oily skin, I really don't think this is one for you. If you don't like a glow, this is not the one for you either. So another recent trial I had was the Supergoop Unseen sunscreen. I got this in my FabFitFun box this month. It retails for $34 and it is a chemical sunscreen. Again, it has SPF of 40, just like the glow screen. The packaging's basically the same too. I think it's so pretty. So this one, if you look at the texture, it's kind of like a pore-filling mattifying primer. It feels very velvety. And I'll show you a clip I had actually from that FabFitFun video. You can see it did not add like oil or glow or anything to my face. So if you are someone that needs something that is not gonna look greasy or oily, you would love this. So the Unseen sunscreen is, of course, that it's clear. It is totally undetectable. I feel like even though I know myself and this is not like my ideal sunscreen because I like a glow and I like hydration, I get why people love this. Because if you are looking for something that is mattifying, this is the one. Like, it is incredible. It has no detectable smell. And again, it plays really well with makeup. I do think you need to let it sink in a bit before you start going into town, because this kind of a product's feel, that velvety feel, I do think needs some time to sink in before you go in. And like I've said, with sunscreen, you're technically supposed to let it sink in for a while anyway. But it's got antioxidants, blue light protection, and it's oil-free, so it's helping with that shine control. And again, it's supposed to be makeup gripping. I would say out of the two of them, if one of them's gonna be a little more makeup gripping, it might be the Unseen sunscreen. So I wanted to mention a couple of sunscreens I've tried in the past that I've hated. I don't currently have these because I wanted, before they went bad, someone to be able to use them, but I'll pop a picture on the screen. One that I've tried is from Paula's Choice. It looks awfully similar, packaging-wise, to the one I love. So make sure if you are buying this that you get the right one. But it's called their Youth Extending Hydrating Fluid. It has SPF of 50, and this was a lot thinner, and it's white, and it didn't leave like a crazy white cast. And I know some people like this, but there was something about it that when I would put it on my skin, it's almost as though it did my skin no favors. Like, it just, my skin didn't look great. And I didn't feel like it played very well with makeup either, so I was just unimpressed by it, especially considering I know there are good SPFs out there that I do love. And another that I felt like pilled up like crazy, but is kind of similar to the Unseen sunscreen, is this one from Tatcha. It's called their Pore Silken sunscreen. And it was so expensive. I bought it kind of on a whim at a Sephora a couple years ago. It just pilled up like crazy. I could not get it to work, even when I let it sink in, even when I would apply makeup very carefully by, like, you know, pressing it into the skin and not rubbing. It didn't seem to matter. I couldn't make it work. All right, let's go into my, like, not even ranking, because I can't rank these because they're all so different. But what I'm gonna do is kind of give my superlatives, okay? Kind of like in high school, there was like, you know, class clown or like best dresser or whatever they were. That's what we're gonna do here. But there won't be a class clown. You're not, none of you guys are funny. You're serious business. So the best glowy primer, in my opinion, is the Supergoop Glow Screen. So if that's what you're looking for, this is the one I would choose. The best mattifying sunscreen, both Supergoop right in a row, would be the Unseen sunscreen. So for best tinted SPF, I have a tie between the two I shared about. But I want to explain. The Paula's Choice is the one for you if you have combo to oily skin and you don't want to add a bunch of too much hydration, or no matter your skin type, if you just don't want it to look too oily. And if you're someone that has drier skin or even normal, I would go for the CeraVe one. I think this one is absolutely gorgeous. Like I've said, on its own, but it definitely does look a little more hydrating than the Paula's Choice. Best bang for your buck, again, is going to be CeraVe. It's the least expensive, but it's also, you know, for the least expensive for the same amount of product. The only one that comes with more is this one, but when you look at the price tag, this one's still a better deal. The most hydrating one, if you are super dry, is definitely this Murad one. So if you are looking for one that's gonna really add that moisture in, especially if you're gonna be pairing it with makeup on top and you wanna make sure you've got a nice hydrated base, this is the one I would go for. It's expensive, but it's definitely the most hydrating. And so best overall, it's hard for me to pick because I know what my top three, so should I just share that? And it's a tie again between all three of these. When I want to glow, this is what I reach for. When I'm wanting like a perfected base and I just want to wear it alone, this is my favorite, the CeraVe. And then my favorite general one, so maybe this is the winner, is the Paula's Choice one because I like it alone, but I also love it under makeup. I've gone through multiples of these for a reason. It was a lot of talk about SPFs. I hope that this was fun or helpful. Really, this kind of a video may be less fun, but hopefully more helpful. There are so many SPFs out there, you guys. And so I'm curious, what are your favorites? If I were to do this again in a year after I've used all these up, what should I try? Some of them I'm actually almost through with. The Laura Mercier one's almost gone. This glow screen's almost gone. The CeraVe is actually almost gone. So, you know, we're working through them, but let me know what your favorites are below. Maybe in the far future, I will do another version of this with some other ones because there's so many out there, right? But if you did enjoy this kind of video, I did do one of these, but with drugstore mascaras. If you want to check that out, I will link it up in the eye and down in the description box if you want to watch that one right now. It's definitely a good one to follow up this one. If you have a certain product category you'd like me to do another like battle of style video, let me know what it is. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. I hope you'll subscribe. I upload 3 videos a week and I'd love to say hey to you over on my Instagram. It is at It's Jessica Braun. I post on my stories all the time. I also post reels over there doing like quick little makeup looks. So I'd love to have you, and I will see you guys in my next one.